guilty of what I did, but I just wanted to get something better. No problem. I got you covered. And if you're not going to do it, I'll make it happen. So let's do it. Thank you.
So the river has put So there's a potential for that. There's also some manual trigger options that I'm not going to get into. Now, if you select it as a trigger appear, then the options are going to be selected. Right? They're going to be related to that exit trigger. People are going to be the post. So you can see the options are slightly different. Lastly, if you go to the visibility tab, you're able to determine which pages you want the form to show on. If you want to hide it on specific pages, like maybe you don't want to show it on your sales page, you can specify that here. So if I don't want it on my course front page, I would put /club, because I know that if they were to become a blogger.com/club, I'm going to take that to my sales page for that tab, I don't want it to pop up here. Or if you only want it to show on specific pages, you can set that right here. And also you have the ability to hide the form if someone is browsing the site on their mobile device. Now these features that I mentioned are things that I love, the flexibility that you have here, can really help you grow your list in a non-annoying way. One other thing to mention is if you want to use the widget, you have to have that turned on right here. And once you do, it will automatically show up on your site. Now it may take about 15 minutes or so, but already there, once you have a great tracking code installed on your site. Let's look at the embedded options. Instead of using the widget, you can also use the embedded form. And if you want to do that, this is the form that you use. It simply copies the code and edits the HTML, whatever pages you want to add it to. Now, if you're using WordPress, I have a video to show you how to do that, and I'll tell you a little more about that in a minute. The big downside of doing this by using the embedded form is that you lose all of those extensive elements. Yeah, we'll do that in the other video. The last option is to use the posted version of the form, which is simple to give you a URL to use. It's not on your site, it's on a drip site, but you can send people directly to this URL and fill out the form. This is my least favorite option because I like to customize it just so much by the time. And you just can't do that on these pages, but it is a lot of steps to make sure you don't get it. Alright, now I want to get to know you a little better so that I can better serve you. So the question for this video is, what do you use to add a form to your site? Go ahead and leave your answer to this question in the comments below. This, of course, is just one of the many videos in my series on this. And I promise that if you want this series from beginning to end, you can get through in no time. By the way, if you want to get access to my trick setup templates that goes along with this video series, head on over to becomeablogger.com/tips. In the next video, I cover how to add a form to your WordPress site. In the last video, I recommend you using decisions and forms in your workflow. So take your pick,